Do you know that there's three and only three basic building blocks for any programming language? Find out what they are in this video. My name is Tim Pachalka from the Learn Programming Academy, and in this video, you'll learn that the three basic building blocks for any programming language are sequence, selection, and iteration. And in addition, I'm going to be talking about another programming fundamental, functions, also known as methods. So in the video, I'm going to complete our talks about programming fundamentals that are typically found in every programming language. As I've said in earlier videos, knowing about them will help you to apply them in any programming language you may want to learn. Now, even if you're not planning on being a programmer, this familiarity will help you better understand what programmers need to do to have the computer serve up our very fascinating games, apps, and websites. The real power and beauty, if you will, of a programming language, whether low level or high, is in its ability to combine statements and expressions together in an orderly way so that the program can accomplish its goals. There's only three ways in which programming statements can be combined: sequence, selection, and iteration or looping. What I find fascinating about these three configurations is that they relate really well to how you and I go about each day of our real life. The first building block is sequence. For example, sequence can be a list of things you do every day in order: wake up, get out of bed, brush your teeth, put on your clothes, etc. Now, of course, some of these sequential things can be done in tandem or parallel, but so they can be done inside the computer in parallel processing. Now, a programming example of this using English rather than a specific programming language might look like this. Input a value for the first number, input a value for the second number, add the value stored in first number and second number, and store the result in result number. The second building block is selection. Now, selection in the real world might be you deciding to either ride your bike to work, take the bus to work, or walk to work. A programming example of this using English rather than a specific programming language might look like this. If the traffic signal equals green, then continue. Else, if the traffic signal equals red, or the traffic signal is not working, then stop. Else, if the traffic signal equals yellow, then proceed with caution. And if. The third building block, iteration, also known as looping. So an iteration, or what we call looping, might be you repeating the same sequence and or selection activities for several days in a row. A very simple programming example of this using English rather than a specific programming language might look like this. While I'm hungry, take a bite of my food, chew the bite of food, swallow the bite of food, and while. To summarize, all programs can be written using just these three basic building blocks, and I find that amazing. So just about every computer program contains dozens, hundreds, or even thousands or tens of thousands of programming expressions or statements. I've heard that the Windows 10 operating system consists of over 50 million lines of code. Wow, that's mind-boggling. To deal more effectively with such complexity, programmers break up or chunk their code into smaller parts, generically referred to as functions or methods. A function is a group of programming statements that together perform a task. In the real world, construction projects are always broken up into smaller units or sub-projects to better estimate and perform the overall project. In the software world, we do the same type of thing. Take, for example, login authentication. We could create a function that just processes and validates a username. We could create a second function that just processes and validates a password. The two functions working together become the login authentication process. All right, so that concludes my conversation about software, and I hope you've picked up the basics of programming language fundamentals, even if you don't plan to become a computer programmer. Next up, the fascinating world of the network and internet are going to be briefly explored. Once we finish with that, we're going to be swinging back to programming and getting into much more detail than what we've seen so far in the series. As always, thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Alrighty, this is the part of the video where I'm meant to get all enthusiastic and to ask you, or quite literally beg you, to subscribe to my channel and to like the video, leave a comment, and all that stuff. Well, I'm going to leave that decision in your capable hands to decide whether I've earned a like or a subscribe or a comment. I'd be grateful if you do one, both, or all three. My videos will get out there and in front of a bigger audience if I get that level of engagement, but obviously it's your choice. Alright, so remember that this series was meant to be watched in order, So if you haven't watched from the start, then how dare you watch my video series out of order? Click the link over here to get to the first video in the series and watch that if you want to see the entire series in order. Or come over here and click to view the previous video in the series. Again, your choice. All right, I'm done. Catch you in the next video.